No money, no journalism. This year, one of the biggest media companies in Germany, Dumont, closed many TV channels and gave up newspapers due to financial crisis. Especially traditional media companies have troubled to gain many revenues. But what are the reasons for media companies getting in financial crisis, and what effects does it have?
Since digitalization, over 5,000 media jobs were cut from the US market. This year it's over 7,200, while online companies like Facebook and Google have grown immensely. Financial crisis leads to a downward spiral. Less revenues gain less money, therefore they can afford fewer employees, leading to a reduction of the editorial department, which causes a quality and quantity decrease, and so the audience shrinks. Smaller audience, less revenues. But what effects does it have? More and more companies produce content independently and have their own public relations, so media companies are less relevant. They are more dependent on their advertisers. There is less independent and impartial journalism. The press freedom decreases, and finally, the democracy is in danger. But why?
If there are less journalists, then there's less investigative journalism, then the public will not be as informed as they could be. And if you are less informed about what's happening around you, if you don't know what politicians are up to, if nobody is there who's controlling the powers that be and hold them accountable, then ultimately democracy will suffer, because it means that we, as the people who vote for politicians, for instance, or vote for policies, don't really know what we're voting for. And that's troublesome.
Only 9% of humankind lives in a country where press freedom is good. The situation is best in Norway, Finland and Sweden, and worst in Eritrea, North Korea and Turkmenistan.
For a freelancer, it's always difficult, because you get a word price, and that word price is fixed already for years. And if you work for a regional press, like I live in the countryside, I get 13 cents a word, which is a day's work for 65 euros, which is peanuts, of course. So that's why I see a lot of journalists that actually do some commercial stuff, like writing advertising text or translation.
Digitalization changes many work fields in different companies. Especially traditional media companies are in a big transformation. They need to find a new way to produce content and to gain money to survive. In the end, a media company is just a business that has to compete on the market. But it's crucial for our democracy.